Good morning, class. So, the live online classes. This is a continuation of chapter number one, Medieval Europe, Rise and Spread of Christianity in History, class 7. Okay, today I'm going to discuss the topic Life and Teachings of Jesus Christ. Jesus Christ is known as the Jesus of Nazareth. Nazareth is a city that is in found in northern Palestine, in present day Israel, where Jesus spent his childhood. So, Nazareth is a place in Palestine. This is where? In Galilee. Okay? Not much is known about the early childhood of Jesus. On growing up, he became a carpenter like his father. He also started studying Jewish scriptures. Now, Jewish scriptures, whenever we are talking about Jewish Bible, we are talking about the Old Testament of Christians. Remember that? Okay? This enabled him to see religion in a new light. So, when he was studying this holy book, okay, he basically started, okay, understanding this holy book, okay? And he found out that many religious practices prevalent among the Jews, namely Pharisees and scribes, okay, were against the spirit of the scriptures. When you are reading a book, okay, you have to practice what you preach, but they were not following the holy book properly at the time. Because such practices and traditions basically violated the law of Moses. Now, the law of Moses in the Holy Bible is known as Torah. Okay, Torah. Now, there are a number of Christians, I think so, in this class also, and they know what is the law of Moses. Okay, Moses was the person who wrote these five of laws, okay, and it is known in the book of Torah. Okay, the most important phase of Jesus' life began when he turned 30 years of age. This important event happened was the baptism of Jesus. This important event is known as the baptism of Jesus by his cousin brother, known as John the Baptist. This John the Baptist used to preach and baptize people in the olden times. One day, Jesus came from Nazareth and asked John the Baptist to baptize him. John didn't know what to say because he was just a common man or a regular person. How could he baptize Jesus, the Savior of the world? But Jesus told him that he needed to do this to fulfill his mission. Okay? So John the Baptist, okay, baptized Jesus on the banks of the river Jordan. So on the river Jordan, okay, Jesus Christ was baptized. Okay, or baptized, okay. He placed his hand on the back of Jesus, okay, and laid him down into the water till he was covered, and then brought him back up again from the water. And just as soon as Jesus was baptized, the sky opened up, okay, in the heavens, and the Holy Spirit came like a beautiful white dove and landed on the Jesus' shoulder. Then a voice from the heavens said, "This is my beloved Son. I love him and I am pleased with him." So in this way, Jesus Christ was baptized by John the Baptist. Okay? Now we are moving on to the teachings of Jesus Christ. Now we are moving on to the teachings of Jesus Christ. Jesus' baptism was very, very necessary because a divine revelation, okay, a divine message from the heaven convinced him that the time had come for him to fulfill his mission. He was sent from the heaven on the earth as a human being for a particular mission, okay? He had to free men from the bondage of evil and guide them on the path that would lead them to good over evil. So, good has to win over the evil. To fulfill his mission, Jesus gathered around him a band of 12 disciples or followers known as apostles. A-P-O-S-T-L-E-S, apostles, okay? And traveled through Galilee. The Galilee is the birthplace of Jesus in Palestine for 3 years, preaching the people about God and teaching them about God. He had healing powers and could perform even miracles. Some of the miracles that are written are changing water. water into wine at a wedding feast, healing the blind, crippled and lame. Okay, healing the crippled and lame, curing lepers, leprosy, and reviving his dead friend Lazarus. He used parables, okay, to teach people or preach people, okay. So, what are parables? P-A-R-A-B-L-E-S. Parables are basically short stories. Okay? And these are short moral stories. Now, moral means, okay, basically what is right and what is wrong. Okay? And are moral stories to preach his ideas, okay? A message of love, equality, and tolerance. You have to be liberal, pure, okay? And forgiveness. The parables of Jesus are found in the Gospels of Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John. The teachings of Jesus Christ were very simple but yet revolutionary, because it brought change, okay, in, okay, the people's view, which was summarized, which was taken out from the Jewish Bible known as the Old Testament. This Old Testament is the testament that is used by the Christians even today. He established a code of conduct or a behavior for men as well as women, okay, as well as women, okay. So he basically in his teachings, okay, basically established, okay, what we call, okay, built a code of conduct. This code of conduct or behavior was, okay, number one, unconditional love, okay, for God. This is number one that they have to follow. Number two is true love, okay, for one's name, N-A-I-G-H-B-O-U-R, name. These were the two code of conduct they had to follow if they wanted to become the disciples of Jesus Christ, even men as well as women, okay? Now, you can refer to your book for the teachings of Jesus Christ, okay? Page number 4 in your textbook, okay? Now, okay, Jesus taught that there is only one God who is compassionate, okay? Who is compassionate, loving, and forgiving. To love God means to love and respect fellow human beings. If you love God, then you have to love what God has created. And they are all human beings as well as animals, etc. All men are equal in the eyes of the God. Is the third one. The fourth one is we should love our neighbors, including the poor, the sinners, as well as even our enemies. If the sinners and enemies are loved by our God. Number five is we should help the needy and do good even to those who harm us. So we have to help the needy person and do good even to those who actually hurt us, because the person who hurt us is also the child of God. We should not be greedy, jealous, and arrogant. We should also forgive our enemies and win over them with our love, because the love is the thing which binds us together. Since God loves sinners and forgives them, we should also do the same. Because the God do not differentiate, okay, people because he has sinned or he is bad, etc. Because he has created that person, he also loves that person. So we have to follow the same, okay, what we call things that has been taught by the God. We have to love even the sinners and even the people who are needy, poor, sinners, etc., as well as the weak and even our enemies. With this, I finish this chapter. Hope you find this helpful.